Oh yeah, there was another girl that was in the thingy that won the exam. Hi everyone, I am going to react to Demon Slayer episode 21, Against Core Rules. Last episode, you defeated Rui with the 11th form. Which I didn't know there was an 11 form. Dead calm. So he slashed the head off. And then Shinobu took care of the sister demon with her sword that was this little funny thing that had this something at the end that I think there's poison in there that's made of the wisteria flower, and then he poisoned her to death. Now with the head slashed off, he must be dying, right? Right, because the last time that Tanjiro slashed the head off, he said that he already slashed it off before he did. So the sword's effect didn't actually work, but I don't think he did so this time around. So he must be dying. So yeah, he's gone. I loved it. So before we get into this reaction, if you guys like my reactions. Before we get into this episode, if you guys like my reactions, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And please consider supporting me on Patreon, where you can find the full length early access and polls and stuff at patreon.com/freethemini. So, let's check out this episode, and here we go. Okay. That ending scene with the Hashiras, man, that was so cool. They all look so cool. So, Tanjiro woke up and they were like standing there. Like, they're the same ranks as Giyu and Shinobu, right? So, like, they all look so cool. So, I wonder why are they like there standing in front of him? I don't know. I was about to say that there wasn't much happening this episode, but I guess not. Let's just say that there wasn't much action happening this episode, because I mean, after all the actions that we've seen so far, we're trying to deal with Rui and his demon family. Like, it's nice to have an episode that's not focused on defeating whatever. The backstory of Rui, I'm like, I've been saying for like I think two episodes now that I don't really care about his backstory, but then when he sort of got reunited at the end there with the parents and he was crying and he said I'm sorry, like that got to me. So apparently he was a very frail kid. He's not allowed to go outside a lot. It's, you know, he doesn't run, he doesn't do much because he's so weak, I guess. And then Muzan comes in, turns him into a demon. But then the fact that he's a demon means he's eating people, and that's not really the parents, the family is not really approving of that. So they're like, we can't just let him continue. And the father was about to kill him. The mom was just crying in the corner. And then he gets up and he killed the whole family, sort of. But then as the mom was about to die, she said that I'm sorry. Like, she's blaming herself for how it all ended, because she's saying that she didn't give birth to a strong kid. So she's putting the fact that Rui became a demon and is eating out, now eating people, she blames it on herself. And the father was also like, I will join you later or something. Like, after he kills Rui, he's gonna kill himself too, because he can't live with the fact that he killed his own child. But all that did not register in Rui's mind when he killed all of them. He was just saying that the fact that they tried to kill him means that they didn't actually care about him and that their bond was fake. But then it was after they died that he realized, no, these people actually cared about me. And he's been feeling this guilt about it. And then Muzan comes in and he's like, it's all their fault. They just can't handle how strong you became or something. They can't accept you the way you are. So he decided to hold on to that. And he's been trying to recreate this bond that he had with his family. But no. And then he was like, now that I'm dying, I'm probably not going to join them, see them again or something. But then that little reunion with the mother and the father, that was kind of nice. And then Giyu, Tanjiro saw how much, you know, how he feels stuff when it comes from the demons. He feels the emotions and everything. So feeling that Rui was feeling so guilty about what happened, like he felt this compassion for him. Then he rested his hand on him and Rui was feeling how warm that hand was and stuff like that. And then Giyu comes, he's like, don't feel compassion for the demons, you're just supposed to be killing them and that's it. And Tanjiro's like, yeah, like I agree, I will kill them, but that doesn't mean that I'm not gonna feel compassion for these demons that used to be humans, and that the fact that they became demons doesn't mean like they don't feel all these feelings that we humans used to feel or something or other. So he was getting angry and he's like, because Giyu had his foot on the on Rui's clothes, right? So he's like, get off of it. Then all of a sudden, like what he notices, and let's go there on the floor, right? And then all of a sudden she comes out of nowhere and was about to kill Nezuko. Like, yo, don't you dare kill her. But then Giyu was like standing in the way of that. He's like, I'm not gonna let you kill this, like, Nezuko. Even though she's a demon and they're demon slayers and that's what they're supposed to do. So Shinobu was not understanding that. He's like, are you actually trying to stop me from killing her? Then Uchi turned around and asked Tanjiro to leave because that Nezuko was a demon. And Tanjiro said, yeah, but she's my daughter, she's my sister. He's like, oh, poor kid, I'm just gonna kill her gently. I'm like, yo. Oh my gosh, that was funny to me. Like, I understand her, like, what she's saying. Like, because Nezuko is his sister, he doesn't want to make her suffer as she's killing her. I'm like, I don't know. But then Giyu tells Tanjiro to, like, go and take Nezuko run away while he's delaying Shinobu. And then, as they were running away, there was this girl running on the trees or whatever. I saw the girl, and then they cut to I saw her running, but didn't actually show her face. And then they cut back to Giyu and Shinobu, and then Giyu's like, are you forgetting about her, the other one? Yeah, are you forgetting about the other one? Because Giyu was trying to stop Shinobu, right? But there was the other one that was running after Tanjiro, and it turns out that the other one was this girl that was also there with them at the final selection, that she also passed the final at the selection. Right, so her order was to kill Nezuko, and then she just like knocked Tanjiro down. Tanjiro lost consciousness. I understood it because, you know, Tanjiro, he's been through a lot, so he's weak. So that right there is it knocked him out. I get it. So she started running after Nezuko, right? And then when she was about to slash Nezuko, Nezuko just turned to slash. She's so adorable, man. I love her so much. And then they were running away. She was running after her, and she was running away. And then she's asking herself, like, why is Nezuko not trying to attack her or anything? She's just running away. But she's like, I don't really have to be thinking about that right now. My goal is to kill the demon. And then Giyu sort of like won against Shinobu, right? And while she was about to attack, she had this thing coming out of her boots or something, and she was about to attack Giyu, but then the crows were like, hey, there's a new thing that y'all are supposed to be listening to. And the thing is that they want Nezuko and Tanjiro brought back to the mission, wherever the leader is. I'm guessing that's where they were taking them to. And yeah, so I wonder how that's gonna go. And then Nezuko, not Nezuko, and Zenitsu is now up, like he's been healed, and they're all like mummified. He's been healed. They're taking Inosuke also where Inosuke's feeling like he did nothing, like he couldn't defeat any demon, so he feels like he's not strong enough like he thought he was. So there's that. They mentioned the fact that the guys that were cleaning up, there's like a group that's called the Kakushi group, and then the cleanup crew that clean up after every demon core battle or something. So that's kind of cool, and I'm guessing that Shinobu is the one that leads the Kakushi crew. My thing is the girl that went after Tanjiro and Nezuko, is she related to Shinobu? Because she also has the sort of like a butterfly thing in her hair. So I don't know. We'll see. Thank you guys for watching. And if you like my reaction, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Please consider supporting my Patreon. Where you can find the full length of this and early access to some of the animes that I'm reacting to currently. And you can see the next episode of Demon Slayer right now there as well. Now thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.